want to miss the game tonight.
Cliff, we got two of the highest scoring and most dynamic teams in the conference facing off. If you don't believe me, take a look at this.
Ball in the clear for the jam. Wow! What a beat, Richard. And he jams it. Dietrich John. For the jam.
Jeez, the views are in for a real treat tonight.
Cliff, let's go add some more plays to that highlight reel.
Look. All right, you too.
Live from the Spiro Sports Center on Staten Island, this is Northeast Conference Basketball on MSG. Tonight, the visiting St. Francis, New York Terriers take on the Seahawks of Wagner College. Hi, everybody. Dave Popkin and Tim Capshaw, glad to be along with you. We are just 60 seconds from tip-off in the final NEC regular season matchup. Now, Capper, St. Francis, New York has already clinched the NEC regular season title, and Wagner will play in the 4-5 game. This much we know. What remains, two exciting, up-tempo basketball teams.
No question about it, Dave. These are the two highest-scoring teams in the Northeast Conference, and they're already set up in the same bracket for next week's NEC Conference Tournament, so this should be a great one. This is going to be all about psychological edge and momentum.
Let's take a look at the starting lineups for this game. First for the Terriers.
I tell you who stands out in that lineup is Clifford Strong. What an addition he's been since mid-year.
His head coach is Ron Ganulin, and his 12th year overall is 10th at St. Francis. 125 career victories, and you see what he's done over the past two-plus seasons. He's been great. Now the starters for the Wagner Seahawks.
Hey, last game, Jermaine Hall got 36 points against LIU. He needs to get the ball.
Derek Wittenberg, second-year head coach, needs one win to go to 500 on his career. This season, the best in 7 years for Wagner College. Former star player under Jim Valvano at NC State. The officials, Brian O'Connell, George Watts, and Jeff Smith. We are ready for tip-off in this one. St. Francis in those road navy blue unis with the red and white trim. Clifford Strong and the boys. Wagner in those home whites. They redid the Spiro Sports Center, and this place is really terrific. Jermaine Hall, fourth leading scorer in the league, is certainly one to keep an eye on. He shaved his head after Wagner lost to St. Francis 10 days ago. Needed a change.
Right.
Well, that change has worked. Wagner hasn't lost since.
And he's very, very aerodynamic.
We are underway on Staten Island. The tip-in for Clifford Strong off the Richie Dominguez miss.
What an addition Clifford Strong is. He's just fabulous around the offensive glass. Wagner's going to have to do a great job getting inside and getting defensive rebounds.
Courtney Pritchard, the point guard, gives it up to Jeff Clauder, a great three-point shooter. That's Dietrich Guy.
St. Francis playing their man-to-man defense. They pretty much stay with that the entire evening.
Jermaine Hall feeds Marvin Jefferson. Missed the layup. Richie Dominguez feeds Greg Nunn. Nunn needs 8 assists today to become the only guy to ever lead the league in 3 straight seasons in assists. Die for 3. Jermaine Hall.
Wow, get ready for this type of action all evening. It's just going to be up and down and an awful lot of points, awful lot of shots going up.
Wagner first in the league in scoring, 10th in the nation. St. Francis, second in the league in scoring. Strong loses it. Paul Dottino's with us on the sidelines. Hey, Paul.
Hey, Dave, you know, the big factor today is who does or doesn't get hurt. If you think the injury problem isn't a factor, just ask Howie Dickerman of Central Connecticut State. Within the last week, he lost guards league win and Dean Walker to broken wrists, and that's going to cripple his chances in the tournament. So the key today, keep the trainers off the floor. Back to you.
Paul, thanks a lot. Leaner by Courtney Pritchard won't go. The other big injury in the league is Mount St. Mary's Melvin Whitaker. He's out for the year. Stephen Howard. St. Francis will keep it.
A little out of control basketball going on right now. Time to regroup. On the side, there's Dietrich Dye.
Dye, the former sixth man for this team, is playing so well that they can't keep him out of the starting lineup. a little bit too much. Tabor's Reyes also missed a chippy.
That's what the Terriers should be able to do all evening. That's their major advantage, the offensive backcourt. Get the big guy, Strong and Reyes, on the board.
Jermaine Hall with the lay-in.
Fabulous pass by Jeff Carter, though, identifying the seal by Hall and throwing it over the top. Good vision.
We are tied at two, a little over 2 minutes in. Stephen Howard posting up on Diedrich Guy and an offensive foul.
Watch his touch pass, a little high-low, a little great vision, good seal by Hall, an easy finish. Good basketball. The full court pressure here by the Terriers. Both teams will really, really work it out the entire 94 feet tonight. They really like to apply major, major pressure. They force a lot of turnovers, both teams. Pritchard's still kind of feeling it. He threw the foul right there. Courtney Pritchard went for 30 last week against the Terriers. He was really the lone offensive force for the Seahawks, so he's got some good confidence going. You can see a little bit of pride there by Greg Nunn. He's going to be ready to check him tonight.
First foul on Nunn. Nigel Wyatt checks into the game for Wagner. Carter misses from the corner.
Yeah, Carter faded a little bit on that shot. He didn't need to. Got to keep your shoulders in front of your knees.
Wyatt is guarding Clifford Strong. Nigel Wyatt, the top player on Staten Island last year. The Seahawks were lucky to keep him. Tabor Freyas, the bigger player, posting up on Hall. Stephen Howard got it from three-point range.
Terrific kick out by Clifford Strong. He had an opportunity but saw his terrific teammate, the great perimeter shooter, Stephen Howard.
Howard coming off his worst game of the year in a loss against Sacred Heart. He had 6 points. This is the league's leading scorer at just over 20 a game. So looking for some redemption today. Off the hands of Courtney Pritchard, St. Francis ball.
Some awkward spacing right there. Nigel Wyatt, that's really not his spot, the foul line area. He's more comfortable down in the low post, and it was just a lack of spacing throwing the ball. Watch the pressure that Wagner can apply there. They force a league-high 23 turnovers a game. Reyes is about 8 feet off the block. Wagner will take that all night.
Dominguez for three.
Great pass. That's a big part of the Terrier offense. Reyes' passing ability.
Alley-oop to Hall. Wow. Hey, that's a great dunk. But how about the pass going out of bounds by Jeff Clauder?
Wow.
Clauder was not seeing a lot of minutes a couple weeks ago, but he has gotten back in there and really played well, averaging in double figures for the season. Stephen Howard missed it. Wyatt cleans the glass.
I called Jeff Clauder in the beginning of the year the best passer in the Northeast Conferences. He's making me look good so far tonight. Two key assists.
And if he's not, his teammate Courtney Pritchard might be. Pritchard fouled on the way to the hole. Here's Clauder.
Watch the recognition, the balance. On the run, he throws that alley-oop pass. Great slam by Jermaine Hall, but what a pass by that guy, Jeffrey Carter.
Second foul on Greg Nunn. He was also in foul trouble the last game we had St. Francis against Monmouth when the Hawks beat the Terriers. Nunn heads to the bench. Jamel Smiley in the game. Wyatt couldn't make it from 2 feet.
Dominguez is grimacing a little bit coming up the floor. Just what Paul Dottino was talking about. You can't afford an injury tonight.
Wyatt with another rebound. Wagner with the ball down four. Not Jermaine Hall's fault. He has 6 points.
Lack of defensive balance when the shot goes up. Jamal Smiley made a big mistake. The point guard and two gotta be back.
2 point game. Howard saves it on the near side. Dominguez can really fill it up. A 1,000-point scorer at St. Francis. Reyes tried to force it.
Great defense by Dietrich Guy, recognizing the backdoor cut.
He leads the league in steals. Jermaine Hall, unbelievable so far. He has all 8 of the Seahawks' points. We are tied up.
Well, that's the emphasis Coach Derek Wittenberg placed on this team about 2.5 weeks ago. He said, wow, what a screen in the backcourt. He said, we want Jermaine Hall to touch it 35 times a game.
Reyes missed it from 14. Hall threw it to the wrong guy.
There's a little too pumped up right there.
At the travel on Howard.
Speaking of pumped up, a little skip by Stephen Howard.
Official timeout. 14:49 left in the first half. Jermaine Hall and Wagner have 8 points. St. Francis has 8. Don't go away. This is Northeast Conference Basketball on MSG. Northeast Conference Basketball is brought to you by RCA, changing entertainment again. www.rca.com. And by Dime, you're worth more at the Dime. And by Solomon Smith Barney, the official investment firm of the Northeast Conference. See how we earn it. Along with Paul Dottino and former Wagner head coach Tim Capstraw, Dave Popkin with you at Wagner College. Jermaine Hall has 8 points. St. Francis has turned it over 5 times. Wagner only 2. Field goals made pretty even, but the Terriers need to get more looks.
No question they need to handle the ball against the Seahawk pressure.
Eve Kabor in the game. Diedrich Dye short on the three-pointer. Howard tracks it down in the corner.
It's a big game for St. Francis. They're coming off an awful loss last week in their most recent game against Sacred Heart. They actually lost 3 straight road games. Wagner's won 3 straight, so momentum is huge.
Paul blocks the shot by Patrice Devineau. He's doing it all.
And what they might want to have everybody shave their head. They're going to keep that up.
3-point basket for Hassan Wilkerson.
Wilkerson looking very comfortable. He's really upped his field goal percentage, one of the most improved percentages in the NEC this year. He's really shooting the ball well.
Bumping foul on Kabor. Not a shooting foul. Neither team close to the bonus.
There's Eve Kabor right there. And if you see that, the orange band around that, that's in recognition of the people that passed away at Oklahoma State University. So a really, really special, nice thing that the Wagner program is doing in recognition of a program that really isn't in the same neighborhood, but yet understanding the turmoil that that program has gone through.
Ball knocked away from Howard. Still plenty of time on the shot clock, 18 seconds. Holding foul out top. Looked like it was charged against Courtney Pritchard.
You can just see the amount of ball pressure that Wagner can apply. Coach Wittenberg wants that type of pressure. Just wants him to be a little bit smarter. When they start to drive, you have a little bit more space, but still maintain the intense pressure.
Look at the two players on the floor right now for Wagner were high school teammates, Hassan Wilkerson and Nigel Wyatt at Curtis High School here on Staten Island. Wilkerson trying to guard a man from behind, charged with his first foul.
Well, that's about 3 fouls in about 20 seconds for the Seahawks, so they're going to have to play a little bit smarter than that, be aggressive, but maintain intelligence.
Dominguez triggers the inbound. Howard, a long three, yes!
Stephen Howard can light it up. He's had enormous games, 30s, 35, 40 this year. He can really, really get it going.
Howard has 6 in the first half. We are tied at 11. Just over 13 minutes left in the first. Courtney Pritchard packed in the act.
How about the confidence level of Courtney Pritchard the last couple weeks? He's really stepped it up. There's Stephen Howard attacking him defensively. It's one of the things you like to do. You like to put the top player on the opposition, put a little pressure on him defensively. That time, Pritchard really took it at the hole.
They've done exactly that. Stephen Howard has 2 fouls. He has to come out of the game. They'll join Greg Nunn on the bench. 2 seniors out of the 4 seniors in the starting lineup for Ron Gagnon. A definite factor here in the early going. Pritchard makes them both.
Wagner setting their 2-2-1 pressure off the free throw. They'll come at you a lot of different ways.
Jason Morgan has the ball. He's in the game to replace Howard. He lit it up last time we had him on MSG. 20 against Monmouth. Strong. Couldn't do it. 7-0 does.
That's what the Terriers need to do. Just work the blocks. They don't need to play too much on the perimeter. Just work the Seahawks down low.
Jermaine Hall has 10.
He's just so quick. So quick in the lane. He always goes off that right shoulder.
Smiley trying to break them down. Going after Strong. And one.
The right and left blocks need to be used by the Terriers the entire night. Right there, Clifford Strong has an enormous advantage. He's powerful, he's big. Look at this, great feed by Morgan, identifying the defense, and that's where you need to get it, down close to the basket. Use the rim to protect. to shield off Hall and was able to complete, going now for the three-point play attempt.
Reyes comes in to replace Thévenot. Clifford strong. Great over his last six games, averaging nearly 20 points per contest. He completes the three-point play.
Clifford Strong is really presenting himself as one of the top players in the Northeast Conference as far as I'm concerned, and I think a lot of people, he just kind of came in mid-year and he's really, really made a difference for the Terriers.
St. Francis with a one-point lead. Marvin Jefferson takes a seat for Wagner. A steal by the Terriers. Jefferson in there for Nigel Wyatt. Reyes missed the layup.
All of the Terriers' success has been on the offensive backboard. When they can give themselves second shot opportunities, look at that guy, Clifford Strong. We're mentioning his name an awful lot so far. Great name, too, Cliff Strong. Just sounds like a player.
Good name for a power forward.
Kind of got that soap opera name thing going, doesn't he? Cliff Strong, Days of Our Lives. Doesn't it?
It really does. He really does.
Hey, I got one for you. How do you figure out your soap opera name? This is what you do at home. You take your middle name and the street you grew up on, and that's your soap opera name. Play along at home. Back to the action.
Can I play along?
All right, Vic.
Mine would be Joel Sylvania.
I love it.
It works. Steal by the Terriers. Wagner's getting sloppy on the offensive end. Jason Morgan double team.
Good wrap around.
So good passing by the Terriers. Strong is fouled again.
Great play by Jason Morgan on the wraparound from the corner. Thought Reyes was going to take it. But very unselfishly got it to the big guy. We keep talking about Clifford. Check this. What a wraparound. I like it. And Haberth being unselfish, getting it to the Cliff Strong. Enough about his name.
Strong a little bit.
Don't say it.
Too much on the free throw. Kabor playing with two fouls now. Strong has 6 points. Junior out of Bishop Laughlin High School in Brooklyn. Reyes rebounds the miss. Kabor for three. Some wild action here.
Great stuff. We talked about in the beginning the two highest scoring teams in the NEC. There's a lot of talent, a lot of action. Activity out here.
They want to go. They whistle away from the ball. Touch foul on somebody. Call on the far side by Jeffrey Smith.
All right, so the Seahawks now are in the 1-1. That was their seventh foul. There's 11:13 remaining, and you can bet the Terriers just need to exploit the Seahawks on the free throw line. They could make their free throws the remainder of the first half. Got to give them a nice boost.
We've heard more whistles in the early going than Times Square in rush hour. Smiley misses the front end. St. Francis, New York leads Wagner 5-2 in a battle for New York City teams here in the Northeast Conference. And another foul.
Chris Jackson and Haberth Reyes battling for position. You got Chris Jackson a little too aggressive in the upper body. Just exactly what we talked about. It's going to be a little bit of a free throw contest for the first half.
Second foul on Chris Jackson. Jermaine Hall back in the game for Wagner. They shuffle players in so frequently. They use 11, 12 guys. There are a lot of players on the Wagner roster that average 4, 5, 6, 7 points. You know, they see about 20 minutes a game for Derek Wittenberg.
I just think that's really healthy for team chemistry. And when ball pressure and intensity is really your theme, you need to use a lot of people. And I think that's why Wagner's been able to regain their energy late in the season, because there's a number of guys getting an opportunity. They struggled about 3 weeks ago. They're a little stale. They picked it into overdrive. But at least the last three games, they played very, very well.
Reyes, the big guy from San Antonio, Venezuela, makes them both. 18-15, St. Francis. Reyes makes it 19. Jermaine Hall has been terrific. We'll be back.
Jermaine Hall gets on the right block. Good feed by Pritchard right there, but Thévenot making a mistake going over the left side as Jermaine Hall loves to drop step off his right shoulder. What a first half that, that guy's having.
10 points for Jermaine Hall. You can tell that March is just about upon us. The Crazies are out. A great crowd here at the Spiro Sports Center and Wagner. Both of these teams have already clinched spots in the NEC tournament, which will begin next weekend. We'll have those games for you on Fox Sports New York. Off of Nigel Wyatt, out of bounds in favor of St. Francis. The Terriers get a bye in the first round. Wagner, shown there, will either be the fourth or fifth seed, depending upon if they win this game today. Either way, they'll play LIU.
Right, today they're playing to see what jersey they're going to wear. You're going to either be the home team or the away, so the green and white, the equipment people are getting ready to figure out.
In the early going, the Terriers have a five-rebound advantage. Richie Dominguez in the lane.
Another perfect feed by Reyes.
Three ball miss. Good rebound by Eric Thompson, a freshman out of Lincoln High School in Brooklyn. The runner goes for Jason Morgan.
Great transition right there. Paul Sanders to Jason Morgan, getting it going. Very impressive.
And just like that, St. Francis runs out to an 8-point lead with 10:15 left here in the first half. Getting out and running.
Watch this outlet right here. Carl Sanders not keeping it on the floor much, having great vision. Morgan exploding down the left side, completing the play. Hey, the Terriers need this game. Good transition. Watch, kicking it up, Carl Sanders out of Grady High School to Jason Morgan. Jack Ringel, the coach over at Grady High School. Carl Sanders hit the game winner to win the championship in the PSAL championship a few years ago. I'm sure a lot of people remember that.
Saw the big run by Ron Ganulin's team. Here's a look at the last couple of years for Ganulin. He's been in the heat of spot in the semis because of that bye. Is this the year?
Boy, there's an awful lot of people in metropolitan New York and really in college basketball that are rooting for Ron Ganulin. He's one of the real gentlemen in college basketball. Look at the turnaround. Look at the job he's done here the last 4 years. This is not an easy situation. St. Francis is not one of those plum jobs in college basketball, but he's used his resources well and really, really been an impressive program. There he is right there.
The Terriers struggled in the mid-90s, but in the last 4 years, Ron Ganulin is 53-19.
Wow.
Former assistant for Jerry Tarkanian at UNLV when they won the national championship in 1990. Larry Johnson, Stacey Austin, and friends, Greg Anthony. Wyatt slices down the lane and hits.
Joe Wyatt did a great job saving that offensive possession. It didn't look like much was going on for the Seahawks, but he showed us some agility from the high post area.
Terriers with the ball and a 6-point lead. They will keep it after Pritchard tipped it out.
A nice freshman here with Wyatt and Pritchard on the Seahawks. Coach Derek Wittenberg doing a heck of a job on the recruiting trail.
If they don't win it this year, Wagner has a great shot next year. No seniors on this team. Jermaine Hall, a sophomore, with the block and steal. Dive for three.
Great vision by Eve Kabor, spotting up Dedrick Guy in transition. You must locate Dedrick Guy. He can really, really drill him from deep.
Jason Morgan, offensive foul, major collision. He's hurt. Don Hovey is the trainer for St. Francis. See if he comes out. Morgan hit the deck hard.
Hey, credit Dedrick Guy. What a great sequence that was. He bangs it three on one end. Watch this right here. You're going to see Morgan slip the screen. Seeing the advantage. A little back cut. Carl Sanders feeds and great rotation by Dedrick Guy. He spotted up and nailed the three, and then he played great team defense on the other end.
Courtney Pritchard and Wagner down three, 9:05 left in the first half. Kabor, kaboom!
You can see the freedom that Derek Wittenberg allows his players. Right there, not just a point guard. He can crank it from deep. He's allowed.
We are tied at 23. Three-point shooting. St. Francis more accurate. Wagner sending them up there. 3 out of 8 is not bad.
You take that any day of the week.
And another foul. An offensive foul at that.
Carl Sanders looking to post up. All those little guys always want to be big-time post players, and he's trying to get some positioning on Eve Kabor. There's Stephen Howard returning back to the action.
Howard has 2 fouls. He also has 2 three-pointers, shooting pretty well, but he's got to be careful here.
Might have gotten away with a little shuffle of the feet.
Kabor again, way off the mark.
A wide right by Eve.
Just over 8 minutes left in the first half. We are tied at 23. A very tightly called game. Kabor, that might be his third. It is.
Well, what we talked about, the Seahawks use a lot of players, so that's not a major, major issue. Look at this little push-off and dancing around. Grabbed him a little bit, but boy, they are calling it tight. He doesn't believe it.
St. Francis played in a game like that against Quinnipiac earlier this year when they had nearly 50 free throw attempts. Howard hits the first.
Yeah, well, the thing is, they'll do like the NBA. I mean, they'll post up not just their big man. That time it was Stephen Howard posting up, and that's always a tough guard for the opposition's guards. And right there, Eve Kabor was forcing the foul. What a major size advantage. It's a two-guard at about 6'3", 205.
8 points now for the senior from Watertown, New York, Stephen Howard. He is certainly a candidate for NEC Player of the Year. Right up there with Monmouth's Rahsaan Johnson. Pritchard finds Dye. Three ball. Missed it.
You see an awful lot of teams using ball reversal from underneath the basket. It's a great way to identify players on the other side.
Sanders. Another foul, and they are...
Carl did a good job of getting all the way down, but he probably should have settled for the open 8-footer as opposed to taking it into the contact. Bad mistake by the point guard.
Derek Wittenberg and Wagner down 2, 25-23, 7:45 left in the first half. You're watching Northeast Conference Basketball. St. Francis, New York on top of Wagner, 25-23. Dave Popkins, Tim Capstraw with you, and Paul Bettino is standing by with a special guest.
Dave, Terry Gallagher, the coach of the Wagner women's team, has got a game on Saturday, a first-round game in Trenton. It'll be on yahoobroadcast.com. You did that by beating St. Francis, New York today by 7. A huge win for you.
Oh, yeah, it was a great win for us. Obviously, we needed to win today to get in to the tournament, and our kids came out and they played hard.
All right, now what do you need to do to make some noise down in Trenton?
Well, I think we just need to continue to play hard, play defense like we normally do, and do some work on the offensive end.
You'll get the 6th seed. I believe Sacred Heart or UMBC or LIU are all still potential opponents. How do you see it sizing up?
Well, I think it depends on tomorrow night's game, but I think we'll be okay. I mean, we did a good job against LIU. We lost by 1 to UMBC, but I think we'll be okay. We just need to do a little bit of that job on the offensive part.
Coach Gallagher, best of luck.
Thank you.
Back to you guys.
Paul, thanks a lot. We will have the women's championship game on Fox Sports New York on Monday, March 5th, the 5 p.m. game. We hope you can join us, and perhaps the Wagner Seahawks will be there on Fox Sports New York.
Well,
Smiley pushed.
That was a nice veteran play by Jamal Smiley, knowing that Wilkerson was coming down to the side of him. He cut off his path. There's a veteran play right here. You just suck into him. They always call that on the defense. Very clever move.
Third foul on Hassan Wilkerson. Field goals made pretty even. St. Francis will be in the double bonus because Wagner has committed 10 fouls. 17 fouls already. Still 7 minutes and change left in the first half. The strike. Check out the free throw shooting. Wagner, one of the best in the league. St. Francis
the pack. A much different defensive emphasis for the Terriers. They're really, really trying to slough down and really trying to work hard against Jermaine Hall. They got Habirth Reyes. They're really trying to push him to do a better job against Jermaine Hall.
Solomon Edwards in the game for Wagner. Nigel Wyatt on the block. Rebounded by Morgan. Terriers, first place team in the league. With the ball, up three, 6:44 left in the first half. Dominguez
might get three. Caught Morgan a little bit off stride, but Richie Dominguez trying to feed out of the low post. As that defense we were talking about, Habirth Reyes, you know, when the offense goes that far off the block, you got to just kind of give up and say, hey, take it and I'll play behind you. Habirth not being smart, but you can see that Coach Ganulin and the staff are really trying to motivate him defensively and make it tough for Hall to shoot over. That's obviously the key to the game right now for Coach Ganulin. He's saying, hey, we've got to contain Jermaine Hall.
Hall already 10 points today, second in the league in field goal percentage, tied for fourth in scoring. Craig Nunn back in there. He's playing with two fouls. And with all these early foul calls, it will certainly be a factor. Who does it hurt more?
Well, I think that it hurts, it hurts the Terriers a little bit more because they kind of rely on 6, 7, 8 guys, and the Seahawks can go 10, 11 deep. But if, once again, at this level, it really depends on who has the foul trouble. If that guy with the new shaved head gets in foul trouble, that's a major factor for the Seahawks.
So far, he's okay. Hall makes one of two. Dominguez was strong.
Great feed by Dominguez, but a little bit of lack of communication by the Seahawks. That was a little too easy. Guys not picking up and communicating in transition defense.
8 points for Clifford Strong, the transfer from Loyola, Maryland. Ball lost it. Strong on the steal. Even Nunbuddy traveled, but nothing was caught.
How about those high screens by Habirth Reyes? Knock you for a loop. Future guy, a tough guy, though, just recovering, digging in. Look at him.
Stephen Howard has been kind of quiet, finds Dominguez. 8 on the shot clock. The fadeaway.
That's the beauty of the Terrier offense. When there's nothing really there in the flow, they got the ability to break down and shoot over. Richie Dominguez, just one of their weapons.
7-4 Dominguez. Dye throws up an air ball. Allen on the break. No continuation. Foul on the floor by Dietrich Dye.
Watch this unselfish play right here. Richie Dominguez evaluating his options a couple of possessions ago and seeing Strong just running down the lane. That's what we talked about, the lack of communication. Two guys regarding Dominguez and left Strong wide open. On that last possession, Stephen Howard might have hurt himself, might have hurt his opportunity for an easy two by trying to create the contact. He probably should have just taken it to the rim.
Stephen Howard hits the first free throw, 31-24. St. Francis on top with 5:13 left here in the first half.
There he is, my man with the pork chops. I called him a cross between Elvis and Eminem. He kind of liked it.
Well, both of those fellas pretty offensive in their day. And Howard is the most offensive player in the league, so it's fitting. St. Francis matches their largest lead, 8. A 6-0 run by the Terriers.
Jermaine Hall has to get his touches for the Seahawks to be successful. It's all about where he gets it. It's about location. That's not his favorite block right there. He likes to usually go to the other side. Look at Reyes work in the low post.
Pritchard has been off. Morgan scans the rebound. Morgan left wide open.
We saw Morgan really drive. go for five threes. That's a great perimeter ability.
Solomon Edwards, somebody got a piece of it. Rebounded by Strong.
Yeah, Dominguez with a good effort. Terriers looking to push. They haven't felt good about themselves in quite a while. They need a great performance tonight to jumpstart them into the NEC tournament.
Terriers trying to snap a three-game road losing streak. They don't need this game numerically, they just need it mentally to go in with a win. Over the head of Strong, Wagner ball.
Oh, Trent Grangagnon staying composed. The team's played well the last few minutes. He's going to let Richie slide on that last heave over the head. And, boy, he works hard. You know, you try to stay cool in this game, and you just tend to explode. Good to see Carter back in the game. Remember his great... Remember, Jermaine Hall didn't touch the... hasn't touched it an awful lot. Let's see if Jeff Carter, who's the best passer in the NEC, in my opinion, can make some key feeds to the big guy down low.
That is a great point. Hall has been quiet the past 6 or 7 minutes. They tried to get it to him, but another turnover. Carter will also help the three-point shooting. Wagner is only 3 of 13 in this game. Strong finds Dominguez. You can't throw over Jermaine Hall.
Yeah, he's got great quick hops.
Hall does get it down low, and he hits.
You gotta tell your defenders to take away his right shoulder. That is where he loves to dip and dive and get to the hole.
13 for Hall. Offensive foul on Smiley.
If the Seahawks can score, they can set the pressure. They set their 2-2-1 pressure. And Courtney Pritchard did a great job drawing the contact.
First foul on Smiley. 3:02 left in the first half. Jermaine Hall and Wagner trailing St. Francis, New York, 32-26. We'll be back with more on MSG. 3:02 left in the first half. St. Francis leads Wagner 32-26. Derek Wittenberg was quite a player in his day back at NC State.
Wow. Hey, anybody knows anything about college basketball can remember this fabulous run. There's Derek Witt from the top. And from the corner, a lot of people don't know, he broke his foot 7 games into the season. And this is one of the most famous plays ever in college basketball. The pass to Lorenzo Charles. That's what Derek Wittenberg called it. The pass to Lorenzo Charles.
The Hail Mary heave that resulted in NC State upsetting favored Houston in that championship game.
Still looking good. Look at him, not bad. Pretty good shape. We all put on a couple LBs, but Derek's looking solid.
He'll be glad to know your review.
Thank you. Looks a little like Larry Johnson, doesn't he? He's got a little Larry Johnson. I'm waiting for him to post up somebody. A little bad feed right there to Jermaine Hall.
Is there such a thing?
As what?
A bad feed to Jermaine Hall? You got to get it to him.
Now you got to find the correct angle. That time they didn't dribble it down to the baseline deep enough to provide the proper angle. Don't be stumping me like that, though. It's not easy.
Come on, you're a professor now. You should get these things.
Here's the pressure by the Seahawks. Reyes, the big target. And on it, the big man out top.
St. Francis by 6, 2.5 minutes left in the first half. Nunn beating Reyes. Reyes is almost like a point guard down there, always looking to pass first. Howard, nope. Flip Strong travel.
Good job on the offensive backboard, but he shuffled him a little bit. Brian O'Connell. I think Marvin Jefferson thinks he might have caught a break right there. Thought he might have made some contact with Cliff.
Turnovers this season, Wagner the best at forcing them. St. Francis struggles. Tonight, the Terriers have turned it over 13 times, so that is Wagner's forte.
Well, that's how they offset their size disadvantage. They create more opportunities via turnovers.
Gabor handling off top. Pritchard at the off guard. Jefferson for three. Wagner has struggled from the arc. Dominguez. Over the back foul on Clifford Strong.
Cliff can't catch a break the last couple of possessions. Trying to be aggressive on the backboard. That time Dominguez had a 2-on-4 and he pulled. He does have permission to do that.
First foul on Strong, one of the only guys who were on Ganulin, not in foul trouble. Marvin Jefferson, a sophomore from Woodbridge, Virginia, going to the line, a 71% shooter. Wagner, excellent at the free throw line, second as a team in the league. Marvin with his first point of the game. Howard back in there, top scorer in the league. Jason Morgan takes a seat for St. Francis. Kabor there on the bench. Jefferson makes one of two, 5-point lead for the Terriers.
A little trapping over half court. That's a veteran Greg Nunn, knowing not to continue his dribble to get rid of the ball. Setting up the offense, see a little isolation.
Reyes finding Nunn, put behind the help pass. Strong could not finish.
Gotta finish those. Cliff Strong, that's your forte in the lane.
Richard blocked by Reyes and fouled.
Labert trying to swap the little guard. That's his second foul. Courtney Pritchard accelerating, kicking it up a notch. Right here, getting in the lane and going into Reyes. That's what you need to do against the big guys. Don't allow him any space. A real savvy guard out of Southampton, New York. Boy, there's been some good play. I had a great one out of Bridgehampton, right next door. Bobby Hobson, maybe one of the best three or four players ever to play here at Wagner College. In the NEC Championship game in 92-93, Hobson lit it up for about 35 points and actually made me look like a legitimate coach for a while until there was 4 seconds remaining and reality set in for me.
An unfortunate circumstance, partner.
See, Wagner will trap you when you get in the alleys right here.
Timeout called by St. Francis. Wagner with a trapping defense. 1:11 left here in the first half. 30-second timeout. Check out our website for the Northeast Conference. That's www.northeastconference.org. You can visit the NEC on the net and get all the stats and standings. Check out the matchups after today's game for the Northeast Conference Tournament, which begins on March 3rd. Derek Wittenberg's crew will be playing Ray Martin and LIU in the quarterfinal round. Only 7 teams make it. St. Francis gets a bye in the first round. All kinds of good stuff, including archived audio games at northeastconference.org.
How about the job Ray Martin has done at LIU? Very, very impressive job. The addition of Anton Dobie certainly made a big difference.
Rebounding edge to St. Francis, New York by 13 so far. Clifford Strong all over the glass with 8 rebounds.
No surprise there. It's going to be the Seahawks forcing turnovers against the Terriers, getting on the offensive and defensive glass.
Nunn lobs it to Morgan. Missed the 3. Pritchard leads the break. 3-on-3. Courtney Pritchard.
Pritchard caught a break right there. I thought he was had a little too much tunnel vision in that last possession, but stayed with the play. Was able to get the push.
Howard, what a touch.
Good vision. Great skip pass over the top. What a perilous play right here by the Seahawks, trying to advance it too far on the outlet.
4-point game. Shot clock is off. St. Francis holding for the last one. Here in the half, 34-30. Greg Nunn, former high school quarterback. The kick out, 3-pointer for Richie Dominguez. And that is the end of the first half.
Richie pumping it up a little bit. Nice little execution right there. And Dominguez, we had about 6'6", can just shoot over Marvin Jefferson. Very, very impressive.
Watch this little drive and kick. You can't lay off the shooters. Great elevation. Hey, that was over Hall. My bad. Great job by Richie Dominguez out over the outstretched hands of Jermaine Hall.
Dominguez, 10 points in the first half. His Terriers on top by 7. Paul Dottino is standing by with the head coach for St. Francis, Ron Ganulin.
Thanks very much, Dave. And Coach, by looking at the intensity and emotion your club is displaying today, suffice it to say that game against Sacred Heart the other night did not please you very much.
No, and if you were at our practice, you would know that it didn't please me very much, as my voice contests. And I think we came out here with a lot of emotion, and Wagner did too. This is it's almost like a playoff atmosphere. Nice crowd, and I guess both teams are just getting ready for next Sunday.
Well, see, that's another question I have for you, because we know where everyone ranks. You've got the number one seed and the bye, but yet we're seeing a playoff kind of game. Do you feel as though because Wagner's in your bracket, you guys need to prove something to each other?
Absolutely. Paul, that's why I said Sunday, because we don't play on Saturday. The playoffs begin Saturday, and we know that Wagner plays LIU, and we have to play the winner. So this is a lesson we are trying to teach Wagner, that they can't beat us at home, at their place, or on the road.
All right, Coach, thanks very much. Back to you guys.
Paul, thanks a lot. Exciting game. Big crowd at Wagner. 37-30. Terriers on top. Stephen Howard has a dozen for St. Francis. We'll be back. York on top of Wagner, 37-30 here at the half at the Spiro Sports Center. Despite 13 turnovers by the Terriers. Now for our best holding court of the year, I assure you, and our jocular judge, Tim Capstraw.
As you know, in life and basketball, and now holding court, only the strong survive. Tonight we have the top three challengers for MVP of holding court this season. Two will be voted off. There can be only one survivor. First up, Greg Nunn, St. Francis, New York. Here's your scenario, Greg. There's 10 seconds remaining in the championship game of the Northeast Conference. Your team is up 15 points. Please let us know with your best impression how Coach Ron Ganulin would react.
You know, I love you guys, but you gotta understand one thing. We're gonna walk out of here with class, like St. Francis Terrier should. This is the way I want it to be.
Impressive. Next up, Diedrich Dye with his guitar.
You're a terrible coach. That's why you got fired. Dirty.
Impressive. Last but not least, Jarvis Mitchell. He doesn't do impressions. He doesn't play the guitar. He was preseason MVP. What do you have, Jarvis?
I'm a rap. Greg, hit me a beat. Yeah. Now for the MVP, it's a seesaw. Chillin' on holding court with Tim Capstraw. And I just said a line that I never used before. I'm not leaving here until I got a score. We got Jesus on the mix, and I'm on the rhymes, and I'm gonna say one more line. I'm out of time.
You see the candle? As you know, fire represents life. It's time to vote. It's now time to tally the votes. Greg Nunn. Diedrich Dye?
What?
Jarvis Mitchell.
Well, Cowper, the tribe has spoken, it's time for you to go.
Did I just get voted off my own show?
Are you kidding me?
Nah. Hey, goodbye.
Life is rough when you're voted off your own island. I give the MVP to Jarvis. He'll join us in the second half. St. Francis by 7. We'll be back. Hall has 13 points for Wagner College, but it hasn't been enough thus far. St. Francis leads by 7 at the half.
It's time to open up the NEC notebook and take a look at what's happening in the Northeast Conference. Jamal Ragland from St. Francis, Pennsylvania, earns the first Player of the Week award in his four-year career. The Newark, New Jersey native averaged over 18 points per game in a 2-0 week for the Red Flash. He is second among active players in the league in assists. UMBC's Peter Mulligan continued his brilliant freshman campaign by winning his fourth NEC Rookie of the Week award. The New York City native averaged over 20 points per game and propelled the Retrievers into third place alone with a 2-0 week. The NEC tournament field is finally set. St. Francis, New York wins its first ever regular season title, and they get a first round bye. Big year for the Monmouth Hawks. LIU Wagner is the 4-5 game. Central Connecticut and FDU round out the group headed to Trenton. St. Francis, PA just missed this year. Here's a look at our NEC tournament telecasts on Fox Sports New York. Saturday, March 3rd, Sunday, March 4th, and the women's championship game on Monday, March 5th. And the upcoming internet radio schedule on Yahoo's broadcast.com. The next one on March 3rd at 6:30, a women's quarterfinal game. And that's all for this week's NEC Notebook.
St. Francis has out-rebounded Wagner by 9. They've looked good. We'll be back with the second half after this.
In the year 444 AD, the Incas were convinced.
11-2 on their home floor, but they're trailing by 7 to the first-place St. Francis Terriers here at the half. Jermaine Hall was great in the first half. 13 points for the Seahawks.
There's Hall. Drop stepping off his right shoulder. Look at the defensive elevation right there. And then running the floor down to the block, isolating. And once again, working that right shoulder. He really, really loves that move.
Stephen Howard has 12 for St. Francis.
Stephen Howard, one of the premier three-point shooters in the NEC, lit it up. Banged one deep from the left wing and off this skip pass from Jason Morgan, set his feet and drained it.
Wagner down 7. Their head coach, Derek Wittenberg, is standing by with our Paul Dottino.
Thanks very much, Dave. And Derek, Jermaine Hall playing like a man possessed. When you can get the ball to him.
Well, yeah, they've done a great job of trying to defend him in the second half of the first half. The last 10 minutes, they did a good job of denying our guys. We just got to find a way to get the ball to him and score. I think our defense has been pretty good. We just got to put the ball in the basket.
Now, when you talk about putting it in the hoop, though, 3 baskets, I believe, total combined from your backcourt. They've been a little suspect with their shooting. Anything special you'll try to do to break
to make them? But we just keep the confidence.
All right, Coach, thanks very much. All right. Back to you, Dave.
Paul, thanks a lot. We'll take a look at the game summary and round up what has happened so far. Stephen Howard has looked good. Richie Dominguez has 10 to back him up, 4 of 7 from the floor. We talked about Hall, big rebounding differential.
Yeah, Seahawks, that's going to be their issue. They're down 11 in the rebounds, and they're trying to make it up with turnovers. And you know, the Seahawks, if they can start lighting it up from three-point land, they're 3 of 14 in the first half. That would really, really give them a boost. Right there, you pretty much got the usual suspects. You really expect Howard and Dominguez to light it up. They've one of the premier combinations in the country, and Jermaine Hall staying on his hot streak. I think Paul Dottino hit the nail on the head when he said, just a question of getting the ball to Jermaine Hall. Good defense in the latter part of the first half by the interior of the Terriers.
We are underway in the second half. Wagner with the basketball, if you're just joining us, in white. St. Francis in blue. Haberth Reyes with the steal.
That's the defense we were talking about. A little quickness by the big guy.
Richie Dominguez from the wing. Dominguez has a dozen. St.
St. Francis leads it by 9. That's their largest until Jermaine Hall answers.
That's what we talked about in the first half. Jeff Clotter's passing ability. What a touch. Great feet over the top. And we got a special guest here, partner. All right. We got one of my favorite people ever. Jarvis Mitchell of Fairleigh Dickinson University has stepped into the booth. Oh, pumped up to see you.
Pumped up to see you too, too.
Gotta ask you, going against the Seahawks, I mean, being a point guard, I mean, do you think about it, their pressure, the way they can really force turnovers?
Well, I mean, you have to, I mean, because Wagner presses from the word go and presses to the word end. I mean, they get after you from the beginning to the end, and as a point guard, you have to be ready and stay poised, because if you get rattled, you'll be in for a long ball game.
Well, you guys have been playing very good basketball as of late. The addition of James Felton seems to have really, really given you guys a boost. We really enjoyed watching you against LIU last Sunday, and you've continued to get yourself into the playoffs.
Yeah, well, James is a big plus to our program. I mean, he'd be a big plus to anybody's program. Coming, a transfer out of St. John's, you know, so he's been in the big games, like playing against LIU. He was able to help us, and our team is feeding off of that.
Block shot by Nigel Wyatt. Jarvis Mitchell, point guard for FDU, is with us here. Joining us early in the second half, St. Francis, New York, leading by 7. A foul underneath on Cliff Strong, trying to guard Jermaine Hall. Hey, Jarvis, let's talk a little bit about your first-round matchup. It's going to be against the Monmouth Hawks. Pretty good team this year. Rahsaan Johnson is a tough guy to cover. Talk a little bit about how you guys match up against the Hawks.
Well, far as guard Rahsaan Johnson, it's kind of hard for anybody in the country to match up against him. But coming to that ball game, I mean, we split with them during the regular season. And luckily, one of the good things about the playoffs is none of the records matter. So we're just going to go in there to play FU basketball. And I know Coach Callaway will have them playing Monmouth basketball.
Diedrich Dye fouls Stephen Howard. Wilkerson just made it a 5-point game.
Coach Daniel barking him out right there. Howard took him off the dribble. Remember, he showed some three-point shooting ability. That's the beauty of Howard. He can post on the block. He can shoot the three, and that time created the contact off the drive. How about you take over a little bit for me right now? Just give us a little guest analyst right now. I'm just going to... You don't hear this often. I'm going to shut up for a couple minutes. Let's see what you got, baby.
Well, we definitely don't hear that often. You got Stephen Howard, the leading scorer in the Northeast Conference at the free throw line. Crowd trying to freeze him, that's kind of almost impossible. He gets 1 out of 2.
Makes it a 6-point game. Howard has 13.
A little half-court pressure. Stephen Howard with the steal. Pushes it up to point guard Greg Nunn for the layup.
2-on-2.
That's St. Francis basketball in a nutshell. Press, push the basketball and score.
Well, hey, this is what we talked about early. Cliff Strong now is grabbing his wrist. The trainer is looking at his wrist. Here we got going down in transition. Good kick over to Greg Nunn on the finish. But the story right now is Cliff Strong going to the bench. He's looking and grabbing his wrist. You can bet that Paul Dottino will be on the case.
Don Hovey, the trainer for the Terriers, looking on, trying to help out Cliff Strong. Wyatt missed the floater. Well, that would be really difficult for the Terriers if they lost Cliff Strong. He has been their best rebounder. Diedrich Dye's second foul in short order here in the second half.
Was your game plan going against Wagner, was it pretty much to contain Jermaine Hall? Was that your game plan with Coach Green? Are we just going to play your multiple defenses and just see what happens?
Well, you know, with FDU, we have a lot of multiple defenses. Our plan was to contain the whole team. Now, Wagner has a very explosive team, and not only Jermaine Hall can hurt you, he's the bulk of their home, but they got numerous scores that can also hurt you as well.
7 points for Hasan Wilkerson. Good game here, 42-36. St. Francis leads it.
Well, Jarvis, I need this job, so get out of here, please. You're sounding way too good. I need the time, baby.
Okay.
Hit the road.
Before he goes, I have to ask him one question. Habert Reyes hits it from the left side glass, and Reyes comes up limping.
Jarvis, was that rap at halftime on holding court freestyle, or did you think of it ahead of time? Because that was really good.
Oh, thanks a lot. Well, of course I'm going to say freestyle regardless if it was a freestyle or not, because I want the credit to show everybody I can improvise pretty good. But yeah, it was pretty much a freestyle. I had a lot of fun mingling, mixing with Greg Nunn, Dedrick Dye, two of the most and best point guards in the NEC. I had a lot of fun, especially with Kim Capstraw. It always makes it even better.
Yeah, it's easy for you to say. Nice job. Screwed up my name.
Jarvis, thanks a lot. We'll talk to you again.
All right, thank you.
All right, thank you. That's Jarvis Mitchell with us here. Rebound by Wilkerson. Oh, Reyes at the goal line.
And Wilkerson is playing exceptional basketball the first 3 minutes of this first half. That's his sixth point. He's really given the Seahawks a nice boost. He's been the lone offensive threat so far.
Greg Nunn finds Morgan in the corner. Three ball, got it.
See, they're really exploiting the Seahawks' help defense. Hassan Wilkerson really, really helped from the weak side, and the Terriers are using the skip pass to free up their three-point shooter.
5 points for Morgan. Terriers match their largest lead. It's 47-38 St. Francis. Dedrick Dye, basket won't count. He was held by Howard. Paul Dottino, our sideline sleuth, has a report on Strong.
All right, Dave, here's the deal. He was trying to flex his left arm and squeeze his hands, and he was having all kinds of trouble doing it initially. Then after about 2 minutes of massaging and all kinds of creams and so forth, it appeared as though he was getting sub-movement back in that elbow, and he was able to somewhat make a clenched fist. He was saying it might have been a spasm, as it was getting better by the second, but still at this point, I'm not so sure he's going to make it back in. Back to you, Dave.
Paul, thanks a lot. You only hope that if he doesn't make it back in, if you're St. Francis, that he can play by next Sunday.
Yeah, I think that's almost good news. I think when it's not a situation when they're going to take him for x-rays, he was really grabbing his wrist, so very fortunate. There's that screen in the backcourt by the big guy, Reyes.
St. Francis starting to get into foul trouble. Reyes and Howard both have three now. Edwards leading the break. Richards, a shifty one. Oh, missed it. He'll be going to the line for two.
Very shifty. Richard evaluating his options. The spin move. Almost completed a very impressive move in the lane. Look at his spin move. Pivoting. Almost completed it. He'll be shooting two.
First foul on Richie Dominguez. Wagner has Jai, Pritchard, Hall, Edwards, and Wilkerson in the game. St. Francis countering with a pretty long lineup. Morgan, Reyes, Dominguez, Howard, and Nunn. 6 points for Courtney Pritchard, a true freshman, all everything on Long Island the past couple years.
Boy, that was a very peculiar injury as Clifford Strong replaces Jason Morgan. Must have been a kind of spasm. You see that oftentimes in your calves and your feet. Not so often in the wrist.
7 points for Courtney Pritchard. Cuts the lead to 7. We'll be back with more NEC basketball after this.
St. Francis University.
Wagner College on Staten Island. The Seahawks down by 7. 15:56 left in this ballgame. This is the 20th anniversary of the Northeast Conference, and a member of our all-time team is Wagner's Terrence Bailey.
Terrence Bailey stripping, I think that's St. John's Mark Jackson right there, taking it from him. This is one of the premier most... Jackson getting stripped by Dean Borges, if you remember him. And Terrence Bailey, what a high flyer, great player, great talent he was. Look at those numbers.
All-time leading scorer in Northeast Conference history and Wagner history. 2,591 points in his career. St. Francis trying to finish up their regular season with a 16-4 mark in conference. One of the best in recent memory. Howard, three ball, corner pocket.
Big mistake by the Seahawks defense. Cheating off of Stephen Howard. You can't relax. You can't help off of him. He's got deadly, deadly range.
16 for Howard. 10-point lead for St. Francis is their biggest.
Rebound!
Hall missed it.
Rebound!
rebound by Dominguez. Great small forward. Dominguez is a good rebounder.
He sure is. Well, he's got great length, good size. Got a real, real complete game. There's a lot of ingredients. That's why you win the regular season championship with this type of ingredients, including a good passing center.
Howard catching and shooting off of St. Francis. Look like.
Yeah, off of Chris Jackson right there. Cliff Strong battling for the rebound.
Feeling all right.
Yeah, nice. Well, I'm not going to say strong move. I wouldn't do that, but very, very powerful in the lane. Found something.
12-point lead, the biggest for St. Francis. Jackson has been quiet. Jermaine Hall has not.
That's the answer for the Seahawks. They need to go to number 24 and see if he can use him in the lane.
The first signee by Derek Wittenberg has 17. He's been great tonight. Eve Gabor back in there.
That's one of my signees. What a great kid out of a great program, Holy Cross in Queens. Coach Paul Gilberry. He came in as maybe the best coach player I had ever recruited. Very, very knowledgeable. Great when you get those freshmen just coming right in and know exactly what's going on.
Dominguez, rainbow three. Foul on the rebound try. Charge against Stefano.
Trying to drive back on the box out. A little too aggressive. Referee Jeffrey Smith on the call. There's Coach Ganulin. Terrio's going at it a little bit defensively, showing the Seahawks what they got.
3-point shooting. St. Francis has been much better. Wagner 20% from the arc in this game. Hassan Wilkerson fouled by Howard. If it's on Howard, it's his fourth, and it is. Wow, with 13:57 left in this game, Howard will have to sit down for a while.
What a scoop attempt by Diedrich Dine. Let's see, this looked pretty clean from one side. Let's see. Huh? Sometimes it just looks like a foul. Maybe he didn't feel like he made contact, and look at him. Like that song I always say, it wasn't me. Look at him, it wasn't me.
Wilkerson misses the free throw. Howard may have gotten some arm on that one, though. Jason Morgan in to replace him.
You ever notice basketball courts in prisons got an awful lot of innocent people, don't they? So where'd I bring that one from? Holy smokes.
Wasn't me. Howard having a big game, but now hampered by foul trouble. 10 points for Hassan Wilkerson. Jason Morgan. St. Francis all over the offensive glass. Clifford Strong fouled on the floor.
Talked about that all evening. Clifford Strong's ability on the backboard. Jason Morgan getting a look. And the guys is working hard. There's Dominguez with a tip attempt, and Clifford Strong. What a bonus. I felt like that was the missing ingredient, that extra talented power forward. That's what the Terriers needed. And when Clifford Strong arrived, the transfer out of Loyola, but he was a great one in high school out of Bishop Laughlin. Bob Lucky, the coach at St. Peter's, is Clifford Strong's coach.
Strong off the nice look.
Beautiful look. Richie Dominguez, very unselfish.
12 points for Strong, and a technical called against somebody on the St. Francis bench. Could have been Howard. He's been angry for a while. We'll see.